I'm not sure how much of this I'm going to videotape, because there's all kinds of ring assembly videos out there. You really just have to follow the sheet to come with your rings. This engine's non-turbo, plus it's going to be idling around up the track a lot. We're not going to be, we'll probably take it on the road some, but it's going to spend most of its life tooling around the track. The non-turbo higher tension expander ring, the white one in the Detroit, is what we'll be using for this. One thing I have seen is a lot of folks just put these in and don't pay attention, but the manual specifically says that you need the loose ends that, if I can get it to focus, the loose ends need to point towards the top of the piston. And I don't know if it matters a whole lot, but they specifically call it out twice in the manual. And you don't want them to overlap like this. There's plenty of videos out there to show you that. If you overlap them like that, you're obviously, your rings are going to be way too tight and they're going to break when you go to put them in. But we're going to, if you're assembling the piston upside down, of course they'll point down, but this manual specifically says this should face like this at the top of the piston. These loose ends should point straight up when it's in the engine. But I'm going to film a little bit. There's a lot of videos out there of how to put these in, and the sheet does a pretty good job. Everybody will warn you 1,000 times over, don't let these rings overlap. Make sure you use the right tension. The sheet covers it pretty good, and as long as you got the proper ones. We're trying to keep this all Detroit. We got these, some new old stock ring sets from Detroit, and all of them come in really good shape. None of them was broke. None of them seemed to be warped. So I'm going to film what I can, but probably not really worth your all's time, because there's you do one and they're all the same.
This ring compressor, and then
tested it on some old rings. It seems to work pretty good. We'll look at the position of those rings. I might show them here. Line top gap of second ring, 180 from gaps of first and third rings. So I guess first and third line up. And the middle one goes 180 from it. Okay. Now, pesky.
Point them towards the top. Sure, the scrapers are pointing down. I think you need that ring expander. The manual says you can put these on by hand. Well, you might want a ring pliers for that. Rubber gloves don't help. What got this engine? Well, the second phase, you know, like I explained earlier, we believe the old steel piston seals, the PP seal, they were really crowded up on two of them when they were spitting oil. And I believe that they just ran with all that oil gone, and it just came down and ruined the all the carbon, ruined the. Alright. Okay, next step is we're going to try out our ring compressor. So Cameron loaded this up in the lathe, made this taper match the top taper that's on the liners. So I've seen other guys use these. They usually throw them on here and duct tape them, but this one here, like I said, he put a taper on it and he put a small edge on there that would catch the top of the liner. So I tried it on some old rings and I thought it worked pretty good. You know, the Detroit one's real long, but I see a lot of guys struggling because you got this long tube and it's sort of like the mystery hole. It's like, what's going on down in there? But with this one, you could watch your compression rings go in, and then you could watch the oil control rings go in. You can actually see what was going on a lot better, I think. So I've not used one of them. We got a lathe, so we figured we could make something would work. This is liner number one. The rods are marked, as I said before, which is which. All right, so we're going to oil that up real well. We'll see how this goes on the first one. I'll probably put the rings on all the rest of them and we'll do them separate. But I just wanted to see if this was going to work. See if we need to back up the front before we have any further get this set up. Everything is slick. I need to hold it. also watch those guys with that Detroit, and you really have to push hard on it. I don't know if it's because of all the resistance they have. Guys put a lot more force on than that, though, so I guess. They say in the manual too, make sure it rotates real nice and smooth. If it rotates real good and smooth like that, you probably got it in there good. So, good sign. That actually went fairly good for my first one. That's pretty sweet. I should have faith in the tool. I tested it a bunch with the used ones, and it went right in. All right, one down. And I believe, I'll have to figure out something. I'm going to lay these down here and do the others. I'm afraid them's going to roll off. Now, at this point here, I could put the tote tag back on it. I got a number on this but the rod should identify where we need to put it. All these grooves got cleaned really well. And took an old piece of ring shaped like this one, sharpened it, put it down in there. Double check it, yep, little circle goes up. Pretty nice working with these steel top pistons. We do a lot of top ends in dirt bikes, and it's all aluminum. We've got to be real dainty with them. You know, more modern rings don't have as much tension. Be careful not expanding them too far. Two of the white, and that's the bottom, that's the bottom of the top, that's the bottom, and this is going to be the chrome one, okay. To point towards the top of the piston. Gotta scrape down so the beak looks back. Trying to use this. That was our chrome one for the bottom, and this is going to be our all black one for the bottom. The ramp is pointing down. Now these two are the same on this one, but make sure the scrapers are scraping down. This has got little slots and some more oil to come out. The scraper's working down. If you got these backwards, it'd be a little harder to load, as you can see. When I tried to pull that one out, it definitely is getting gives me more resistance pull down. Got them in there right, because I don't think you can push them in there. Here again, this thing definitely wants to overlap, and a little pick here to pull apart. Boy, that really overlapped. Next one over here. Again, make sure the screw. Alright, see if we can do this one better.
Let's see how this one goes.
Works really good for compression rings. I think it works really good for the oil rings too, because you can see them. I see a lot of those guys with that Detroit designed one, and at this stage, just way down in there in the black hole. And you can't really see what's going on. I think if you got that off, that would be a good indicator right there, because that is smooth as butter right there. Look how far it can be down. I see some guys leaving about halfway out. So I'm going to do about halfway. That's number two. That is smooth twisted. Took all these out and inspected them. This is new old stock. Okay, two compression rings, now five rings. Little circles on this is right there on the dark side. White one on there. Now we're looking for the chrome. Scraper's pointing down. Scraper's pointing down. This is the chrome one. Here for the expanders. If you grab the one on that side, you can pull around without it overlapping. That overlapped. Didn't want to do that, but that's the best thing I found. Pretty hard to get that out. Two picks and you pull it apart, it'll snap back in there. That's some scary shit right there. So now I'm looking for the next one up, which has a white mark on it for this kit. Scraper is facing down. Got one gap here, so we're going to put some gap over here. Day two, they can come up with something different there. They must have 33 warnings in the book about that. Somebody screwed that up a few times. This should be piston 3. Not sure if I took them out before I shoved the piston in there. I can see it. Breaking a ring. my assembly loop. And on my hand, back of my hand or something. two are the same, but we need to have a scraper now. Scraper space. And I believe this is the key to it, man. It says that should be smooth. That's smooth as butter right there. It's a pretty light inward too. I'm not really good with the juice. Alright. Thank you. very smooth, and it rotates real smooth. All right, so it's number five. It's worth trying to pull it out. It's hard to pull out, but it's smooth when it does come out. All right, one left to go. I'm not even sure I'll put this much on the menu. I'm not sure we'll watch as much. That's smooth. Thank you. driving around, so.
Yeah. Piston 6. The last time I've seen these pistons in my lifetime, hopefully she lasts a while. Only had 180,000 miles on it. Not much wear. We'll probably only put 50 or 60 on it, if that much, probably. Runs to get gravel, pull around the track. Hang out with our other autocar we got up there, our water truck. It's an autocar. It's got a Cummins built in. It's doing alright. It's using some oil. For what we use, I think the built in uses oil anyway, a lot of people say, but so far she's been doing pretty good. It's an 84, never was on the road. Last push, let's see what how she goes. Ah, she got a lot of that. Seemed a little rough, but that the ring wants to jump off the minute it falls off. The one design does the same thing, it's just bigger. This seems more violent, but feel nice and smooth. Real easy. Smooth coming out. I'm going to take a break for today and I might clean up all the mess tomorrow.